Hello everyone and welcome in this video.
Yeah, so that's my line. I'll go ahead and get
Jason,
started.
Jason, will you take it from
here? Yeah, so you gotta flare out the hands a little bit more.
I flare in more than out.
Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're gonna be talking about what happens when you put gasoline in a diesel car. Now why you would do this, you know, there's not really a good reason, but someone might do it by accident, or maybe intentionally, or maybe they just didn't know and they thought any fuel will work.
Absolutely. You know, we've seen sort of all the range of people misfueling their cars, anything from some gas stations have green pump covers for diesel and some have yellow, so that's a confusing thing. We had a customer that
two different colors
loaned their car out to their friend, and the first fill up their friend was doing a real nice thing, filled their
car.
They let them borrow their car and they did a real nice thing.
My friend did it.
I don't own a diesel thing. And their friend filled their car with gasoline on the very first fill up. And we've even had where...
I think they just didn't want to admit that they did it.
Very possible. Sometimes you don't want the details.
But the point is that you've actually dealt with this
many times.
And, you know, you have to take care of it. And so what we're going to do is walk through the different components and what will fail and what you'll have to deal with when the customer brings in the car that has done this.
Yep.
So we'll get started with the fuel tank. Does anything bad happen if I stick diesel fuel or gasoline in a diesel tank?
Generally, with the tank itself, nothing bad happens. It's a plastic tank. It's actually not really plastic, but...
composite.
It's a composite tank.
Yeah.
And it holds up just fine to gasoline. What we will do is remove the in-tank pump and clean any remaining gasoline out of the tank.
Okay. Now, the in-tank pump, as you've mentioned, does anything happen with that, or can you still reuse it?
Most of the time, you can reuse the in-tank pump. It really depends on how much gasoline was pumped through it.
Okay.
And that usually depends on how long the car was cranked while not starting because it was filled with
gas. Okay, that makes sense. So, from that in-tank pump, it's traveling through some fuel lines to the filter. And as far as the fuel lines themselves, is there any problem with gasoline in these diesel fuel lines?
Now, these lines we actually will replace. These are under hood lines. The lines from the tank up into the engine compartment, we won't replace those generally. We'll flush that with brake clean and compressed air to get any remnants of gasoline out. But usually those hold up just fine. But once we get to the fuel filter housing, we do replace the entire housing as well as the filter. You can see there's valving inside of the fuel filter housing. So we want to make sure we don't leave any gasoline inside of that, as well as the rubber lines due to possible gasoline contamination.
So is there any problem with using a brake cleaner through those lines at all?
No problem with it at all. Okay. We're not leaving it sit in there for any length of time. It's spray brake clean and then compressed air right
out. Okay, great. So the fuel filter itself, does this have to get replaced?
This comes in as an assembly, so we replace all of it. It's got the filter bin built into it.
So from the fuel filter, we move on to the electronic pump.
Correct.
What happens when you've got gasoline in this?
With gasoline inside the electronic pump, it isn't able to have the lubricating properties like diesel fuel does. So we go ahead and replace that. Not only, you know, a lot of this stuff is... we replace it. It may not be, let's say, dead today, but we worry about long-term effects.
Right. So essentially what you're doing when you put that gasoline is you're increasing the wear rate for that duration.
And decreasing the lubrication properties inside these pumps.
Okay. That makes sense. So from here, we travel to these high-pressure pumps.
Right. Here we travel. We go to the high-pressure pump. This is what jumps, obviously, the fuel pressure up. They're driven by the timing belt. This one did have metal contamination. What we'll generally do, very first thing to diagnose...
So this is out of a car that had the wrong fuel in it.
Yes, this is out of a car that had the wrong fuel in it, as well as a technician that tried to cut it apart. I might be that technician.
Maybe. So what happens with this? Do you replace this?
We absolutely replace this. This is usually where the metal fragments come from. It's a failure of this pump internally. And what we'll do is we'll pull this valve off the top of the pump. And as you take the pump, the valve off the pump, you'll see embedded in the screen metal particles.
So where are these metal particles coming from?
They're coming from this pump. This is the main point of failure.
And like all of the components in here, what's wearing?
You know, actually, this is the very first one I've ever had apart. It could be bearing material, because remember, we're not having anything to lubricate these parts like we do when we have diesel fuel.
Okay, that makes sense.
So it could be any of the components.
Yep, so anywhere you've got metal on metal contact, you're going to be having much more wear because you don't have the lubrication from the diesel fuel.
Correct. And most of these actually do have to go back to the manufacturer. So we are very fortunate to be able to have two pumps sitting here on the bench.
I'm pretty excited about having them both here.
Me too.
Okay, so from the high pressure fuel pump, we of course go to the fuel rail.
Right.
And what happens with this guy?
What we worry about with the fuel rail is pieces of metal embedded into the rail. Obviously, this is a closed unit. We can't really get inside of it and see any type of damage, so we go ahead and replace that as well.
Okay, and that's just in case you've got metal coming in here, and that's just going to cause problems down the line.
Correct.
Okay. And then from the fuel rail, we move, of course, to the fuel injectors.
Right.
And is that the same issue where you could have metal pieces trying to come into here, and so you want to replace these?
Early on, we actually weren't replacing the injectors, and almost, you're not going to be able to open it.
I go rock climbing, and so it gives me phenomenal grip strength and obviously huge muscles. So.
Well, you could see what I had to do to this one to get it separated. So if you can crack that open, I'm going to be impressed.
You used your teeth a little bit.
I did. We go ahead and replace the injectors as well for the same reason. All of these parts you really need to think of in this way. They may not be damaged today, but the longevity of the part may be significantly reduced. It could be fine for another 10,000 miles, or you could put it all back together.
You could just have a little metal fragment sitting here, and it's waiting to just destroy it. And you're waiting and you're waiting, and finally 10,000 miles later, it clogs it up, and then you have other problems.
Or it clogs it open, which will make for somebody to have a really bad day.
Lots of fuel.
We're pumping 800 or so bar through these through this high pressure system, so it's no joke.
It's not a joke. You shouldn't put gasoline in your diesel
car. Exactly. You know, to give folks an idea of the catastrophic damage this really is, if someone were to have to pay for all of these parts, you're looking at about an $8,000 repair.
$8,000. And how much of that is parts?
It's about $4,000 in parts. You could figure probably $1,000 to $1,200 in labor, depending on the area of the country you're in. The other thing you gotta remember is that when gasoline and diesel are mixed, there are special disposal processes that it has to go through. So that is actually super expensive. It's like $25 a gallon to dispose of the two mixed
together.
So
what I'm curious of is I've got $4,000 and $1,000, and generally this costs $8,000.
Well, that's a lot of that is the fuel disposal
fee.
So
it's significantly expensive.
That I just mentioned.
But you said $25 for a gallon.
Yeah. What happens when you have 14 gallons worth of...
14 times 25 isn't 3,000.
Well, you math. I don't math.
All right, anyway, so it's about $8,000.
Don't forget. You can do the math yourself, Jason. Perhaps if we had a whiteboard here, we could actually execute
that
task.
Maybe. 4 + 1, I usually can do it in my head. But anyways.
Unregardless to the $8,000 value, we can agree, I think, that it is an incredibly expensive repair. And these parts have actually come down a lot.
Yeah, and that's a very simple thing to do, to just put the wrong... I mean, it's not necessarily... Volkswagen tries to make it preventable.
Right.
So that you don't put the wrong fuel in. But it's very easy to put the wrong fuel in from it doesn't take a genius to figure it out. And you could very easily cost yourself $8,000.
And think of what happens if the truck filling at the station misfuels the tank, which I've seen happen too. So it can be anywhere along the process can result in misfueling. It didn't used to be this way. The older diesel engines would actually run on gasoline. They ran like crap, but they would run, and we would just pump the gasoline out, put a fuel filter in it, and we'd be good to go. But today, it's quite a bit bigger of a repair.
So what you should take away from the video is that you should not put gasoline in your diesel car, which you probably knew beforehand. But what you may or may not have known beforehand was that you should subscribe to Charles's channel, The Humble Mechanic. And I will, of course, have links all over the place that make it easy to do that.
I think one other thing that they might want to take away.
What else do you think they should take away?
I'm really bad at math.
Well, I wore gloves because I was nervous about touching real parts, and you didn't.
True.
We all have our strong points, and we all have things like gray hair that kind of hold us back in life. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, leave those below.
I do this.